So in order to cook a food, it is necessary to heat the inside of the food up to some critical temperature. And we discussed previously that that critical temperature for most foods, be it steak or tofu or whatever it is that you like to eat, happens to be in the range of 60 degrees Celsius or thereabouts, because that's where the proteins in the food unfold and interact with each other to cause the food to become cooked. We pointed out that there is a paradox, which is that if you look at the recipes for cooking foods, they tend to require temperatures that are much above that critical temperature. So that when you cook a steak in the oven, for example, you use a temperature which is, I don't know, 180 degrees Celsius or so, even though you only want the inside of the steak to get to around 60 degrees Celsius. And then we basically explained or started to hint at the reason why. And the reason why is that it turns out that there are two chemical reactions that need to occur in order for a food to be cooked. One is the texture on the inside has to change, and the other is you need there to be browning reactions on the outside. And we discussed that those occur at around 120 degrees Celsius. So now we want to try to put all of this information together and try to think through why it's hard to cook a steak. So that is the subject of this discussion. If you don't like steak, I myself don't eat steak, then you can really think about your favorite food, why it is hard to cook a potato, why it is hard to cook tofu, why it is hard to cook fish. And whatever it is that you like to eat, what I'm about to say applies. So you might, for example, choose to cook your steak at 180 or 190 degrees Celsius. So we want the internal temperature, which starts out at room temperature because your steak might have been resting on the countertop before you put it in your oven. So maybe the initial temperature is, say, 23 degrees Celsius. You want to raise that up to about 60 degrees Celsius because that's when the steak is cooked. And you also want the outside to get to a temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. Now, the first problem that you have when you sort of think about this. And the problem is, so we want to get the outside to 120 degrees Celsius, is that you'll all recall that the boiling point of water is at 100 degrees Celsius. And the major ingredient of steak is water. And so that means that initially you can't get the steak above 100 degrees Celsius because it's made mostly of water. And water, the maximum temperature it can get to is 100 degrees Celsius before it changes phases and actually becomes a gas. So if you want, so how are we going to heat the steak up to 120 degrees Celsius? The way we're going to do that is we're going to have to evaporate off some amount of the water around the outside of the steak. If we do that and there's no water in the outside, so imagine the whole edge of the steak has no water and only the inside of the steak actually has the water, then the outside, once it's got no water, you can actually heat it up to close to the temperature of the oven or whatever you want. So you can get it up to 120 or 180 degrees or whatever. So if you imagine the temperature profile across the steak, and here we'll draw it. So at the outside of the steak, right outside where the steak is the temperature in the oven, which is, say, 180 degrees Celsius. At the surface of the steak, you'd like to get it to 120 degrees or so, maybe 130, so that you get the browning reactions to be how you like them to taste. There's then going to be a very thin layer where the temperature goes down from the 120, 130 degrees to the 100 degrees, which is the boiling point of water, which is how hot the outermost water layer of the steak will be. And then what you would like is for it to get to be 60 degrees or whatever your temperature is in the middle. And so you can imagine a curve which basically goes down to 60 degrees in the middle. Now the problem is if you achieve this target with the way that one typically achieves it when one is cooking is one puts a thermometer in the center and says, hello, the temperature is at 60 degrees Celsius. The steak is cooked. And you see that that's true in the center of the steak, but the whole outside of the steak is necessarily at a temperature which is higher than 60 degrees because otherwise you won't hit the browning reactions that you need on the outside to create the flavor molecules that we want. And that actually, in its essence, is why, it's one of the reasons why it's so hard to cook a steak.